So coming to gratefulness, if the emotion, bad emotion affects the tree and it can kill so older tree, imagine what gratefulness or gratitude emotion can do to your food. Today, see to your food, relish every bit of the food you are eating today and feel grateful for the food you are eating and tell me how it tastes to you today. In a world conference, Swami Vivekanand has proved that even a steel bar has emotions. That is, he connected the steel bar to the electrodes and the chemical changes can be seen on the particular screen placed over there. And he brought out a sword and was about to hammer that particular rod. Iron rod. So the electrons within the iron rod suddenly changed. They started mingling, they started separating and departing from the place where he was about to hit the rod. So imagine even an iron rod can feel or sense the emotion of being harmed. So those who are eating non-veg food, imagine the animal is about to being slaughtered and the butcher is bringing a knife towards him, how he might be feeling. The emotion is energy, so the energy is trapped within every bit of cell of his body, of either being very fearful or threatened, or being the animal attitude is to revolt or to attack. So imagine either the emotion is of attacking or either the emotion of being very, very terrified. And when you eat the same food, you are actually eating the same energy within you. So when you react to things, if you are a non-vegetarian, you will see the reaction of vegetarian is different and non-vegetarian is different. I am not against that you can eat anything you want, but think over it or give a thought over it. If you want a very peaceful, serene life and if you want your reactions to be very peaceful, milder and want to thank everybody and want to be very pleasing, don't eat non-veg food. I'd like to share experience of mine which I have since my childhood. So remembering that experience of mine, I have a great value for food and I'm very grateful for the food I eat. I never ever waste food. My grandfather was a farmer and whenever the crop used to be harvested, there were bags and bags of crops in our house. There were 60 bags of wheat and many more bags of rice and dals and etc. etc. The workers used to place those bags very properly and used to go off. And my grandfather used to take that broom and used to sweep off all the floor and collect all the dust and garbage and collect that in a pot. And throughout day, he used to sit and clean it all and take out single grain from the dust and garbage, I must say you. And he used to collect them all and take it to our home and used to mix it all in our regular grains. So I was like, you have so many bags, why are you collecting single grain from the dust and mixing it into our food? So he said that the value of this grain is as similar, or these grains are as valuable as the grains in the bags you are seeing, because from this bit of grain I have got these grains. So the emotion with which he was explaining me is still like live in front of me, and for that reason I have a great gratefulness for the food I eat and the water I drink. Imagine many people's don't even have food to eat for days together. You open the tap and you have clean water, you wash face with it, you throw the water, the water is continuously running, the tap is open, you're playing, etc. etc. Imagine people has to cross many villages to bring a single pot of water to their place, and that too the water is very shabby and they need to clean it first and then it becomes drinkable. Imagine people having no electricity for days together and you switch on a light or fan and you keep it on only, and you go into different places, you switch on TV and you do different tasks, you talk on mobile and things like that. So you are taking so much natural resources for granted. You'll say why shouldn't I? I am paying for it. So it's like what you are paying is very less in front of what the value of this natural resources is. Look, you might be having unlimited money, but the natural resources are limited. And remember these words of mine, be grateful for what you have right now. Many people are even not knowing the feeling of having these things what you are having right now. Because of your feeling of gratitude, because of you liberating the energy of gratitude into nature, and it will come multiplied, and every one of us will get them in abundance.